Alright, so hi everyone. I hope you all are doing great today. I hope you all are having a splendid day. And those who are feeling down, those who are feeling depressed, those who are feeling that they can't go and make smile, I'm here to let you know that where greatness is, much is required. And your character is being built through your trial, through your situation. And a lot of times why we're still in our situation is because we don't acknowledge God in our midst. When we begin to acknowledge God, you will realize that things will fall in alignment, things will begin to flow, and though you are going through so much, there will be peace in your storm. So that is my encouragement to those who are feeling down, depressed, and so stressed out by things of life. So today my topic is, what is your lifestyle? And you know, a lot of person would say I have a rich lifestyle. Some people said I have a poor lifestyle. Some people would have said, oh, my lifestyle is normal, it's just like everybody, and etc. But what I'm here to let you know today is that, well, I don't know if there are more lifestyles, but I'm gonna tell you about the two lifestyles that I know about: the carnal lifestyle and the spiritual lifestyle. A lot of person thinks that the carnal lifestyle is just a flesh-based lifestyle, as in you getting up, bathing, brushing your teeth, proper hygiene, doing your schoolwork, and all these lovely stuff. But a carnal lifestyle can go more in depth than that, right? According to the Bible, a fleshly lifestyle would be one that yield to would be disobedient to the word of God. So for example, the Bible said do not steal and you would steal. The Bible would say do not covet and you covet. The Bible would say do not fornicate and you still go out there and fornicate. Do not worship idols and you still worship idols. These are carnal lifestyle. So you not being able to be obedient to the word of God is you being obedient to what God is telling you not to do, which is the carnal lifestyle. Now, with a carnal lifestyle being explained, you must understand what a spiritual lifestyle is. Yeah, a spiritual lifestyle is actually you being able to live in alignment to the will of God. So you're not a lie, you're not a steal, you're not do things that would cause you to be disobedient to the word of God. Hence, you are reading your Bible and praying every day and all those lovely stuff. Not to say you won't fall one and two times, because you know, continuously our flesh fight against the spirit. So you wanting to do, or in other words, the right is fighting against you wanting to do the wrong. So really and truly, it's not easy, but you just have to have your mind set ready to do what is right and stuff like that. So I'm gonna get down in the word of God now. So wait, and before that, us as youth, we know that we find it difficult to do things that are pleasing to God. But look at it this way: if you love God and you really want to please God, you would go the extra mile. Even if you fall or falter, you would go the extra mile to get back in alignment to the will of God, right? For example, you love your parents, you love your friend, you love your boyfriend or girlfriend. You would try your best not to do the thing that would allow them to hate you, that would allow them to cut you off, right? And even if you do something that is bad, that will allow them to be upset with you, then you would actually find ways to gain back their trust, to gain back their love, to be back at that place with them where that you would want to be, right? It is the same thing with God. in this word, he say in Jeremiah, he says that he marries back to the backsliders, which means that if you falter, he's able to take you in with open arms. Even with the story with the prodigal son, where he left his father and he asked his father for his possessions and everything. He went out there and scandal out his money and all of that. And then when he realized that all his friends that were around him wasn't there again when he had nothing, then he realized that the only thing he could do is go back to his father. When he went back to his father welcomed him with open arms. This is the love that God has for you. Even when you fall, when you falter, when you are there living a spiritual lifestyle and then you fall by worshiping other idols, by putting other things before him, you fall by fornication, you fall by adultery, you fall by telling lies continuously, you fall by so much things, and then you feel as if you can't go back to God. I'm here to let you know that God is a loving God, and no matter how much time you fall, then he is always there to accept you as long as you are ready, as long as you say, God, take me as I am. Lord, I just want you to wash me, to purify me, to make me more like you. And it won't be an easy thing, for it won't be easy for you to do, but you see, practice things that you make a habit, then you will realize that it will become much easier as the time goes by, right? So your character won't build one day, it will take a period of time. And as I speak about character, there is something that I want to go in depth with. A lot of times we ask God, I want you to teach me how to be like you. But how can we be like God or be like him if we don't go through things, if we don't go through testings so that he can build our character? I'm here to let you know that most times the things that we go through is to let us know God, is to let us experience God on an intimate level, so that when other things begin to turn in our life, we're able to say, well, God, bring me through this so he can bring me through this. And you know, you might not realize, but I'm here to let you know that your character is being built through these testings, through these trials, through this situation. Your character is being built. And you might be saying, what you mean by this? Look at it. You might be in a situation where you hated everyone, and you know, the pressure began to become so overwhelming, till probably the only thing you had to do was turn to God, and all of that hate become love. Then you realize that you have a forgiving spirit. Why? Because you have been tested in that area, and because you have put God in the midst of the situation, then you begin to overcome through love. So I'm here to let you know that probably the Lord is teaching you patience, he's teaching you how to love, he's teaching you peace, how to have peace, how to find perfect peace in your situation. He's teaching you how to be strong-minded, how to be this, how to be that, because he's building your character. There is great within you, but in order for that greatness to come out, you have to go through things, you have to go through trials, you have to go through tribulation, you have to go through situation, so that you can be tested, so that your character can be built, so that your mindset can be set upon the things of God, upon positive things. And you know, sometimes some of us thinks that, hey, God no one have nothing for do for me, I do to do for me, I do towards me and my life, this is why all of this is happening to me. But to be honest, that is a lie from the pit of hell. Really and truly, what the enemy are trying to tell you, in other words, is that you have no purpose on this earth, and where there is no purpose, there is death. Death equals no purpose. Life equals hope and purpose. And in God there is life, and life more abundantly. So I'm here to let you know that if you are living, while you are living your life, and tribulations, trials, and situations may come your way. Then don't be dismayed, don't be disheartened, because your character is being built for greater. And sometimes you might be saying that you're praying for something for so much years, but every time when God bring the situation to you, you cast it off, you turn your back upon him and all of this stuff. I'm here to let you know that keep pressing in your situation. Keep pressing through prayer. Keep pressing through with fasting. Keep pressing with worship, and then you will realize that everything will begin to fall in place. Now, I'm going to continue with the spiritual lifestyle. Now, when all of these fleshly things come upon you, as in stealing, lying, fornicating, reveling, concupiscence, all of these things begin to come, and you yield to them, then you will realize that you are yielding to what the enemy defines you as. But when you begin to yield to God and all what he has in store for you, then you will be living a spiritual lifestyle. Now, there is a verse in Psalm, I think Psalm 119, where he said that he regards the word in his heart so that he does not sin against God. Now, when you read the word of God, then you should not only read it, you should not only look at it, you should not only be hearers of the word, but you should be doers of the word of God. And when you become doers of the word of God, then your lifestyle will be that of a spiritual one. As I said before, that spiritual lifestyle is not you looking into the spiritual realm, but is you identifying yourself as Christ-like. You identifying yourself as being a Christian, as being the light of this world, as being the salt of the earth. That is what a spiritual lifestyle is. And there's a verse in St. Matthew that says, you know, by your fruit you will know them. Like, if you get up and someone hates you and you love them, if someone tell you something bad and you give them a soft answer, like how the Bible says, soft answer turneth away wrath, then people will realize that, hey, this person is more than just, you know, an ordinary person. You can say this person is Christ-like by their actions and things like that. So I'm here to let you know that even though it won't be easy for you to follow this spiritual lifestyle things, because you will have peer pressure, things will become overwhelming, but I'm here to let you know that when you have a steady mindset, when you set your mind on the right thing, then you are able to accomplish it, because your mind works like this. When you set your mind on things, then you will accomplish it. It is the same thing with the spiritual lifestyle. If you are able to say, I will not tell lie today, I will not steal, I will not bad mind, I will not grudge, I will not hate, and all of these things, then every time when you're probably ready for God, say, may hear, then the word will come back to you. And then you say, oh yeah, the Lord says I should love one another, and all of these stuff. And the word of God says I should not hate. The word of God says I should not steal. The word of God says I should not put in place no other gods above him. So God, I place you in this situation. I place you in my life. Oh God, I place you right here and at this place. I place it in the future of my life, because I see where mighty God, where this person will come in the future and warm faith. Just kill them. But you're saying a word that thou shall not kill. So Father God, I place it in my midst at this moment. I place it in the midst of my future, because and you alone can take me through, right? So when it said in Romans 8 verse 6 it says, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, right? For it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So the flesh cannot please God, guys. Children, youths, adults, the flesh cannot please God. Which is why when we compromise the things of this world, in our Christian walk, this is the reason why we shut out God. This is how we shut out God, when we yield to things of this world. In Ephesians 5, it basically, I'm looking for the scripture in the meantime. In Ephesians 5, it tells you clearly, you know, that if you are his child, that being his children, we should follow him. It says, be ye therefore followers of God as their children, and walk in love as Christ also hath loved us, and hath given himself for us. And it's about fornication and all uncleanness and covetousness. Let it not be once named among you as becometh saints. Neither filthiness, nor foolish talking, nor jestings, which are not convenient, for rather giving of thanks. So all these uncleanliness and things like that, do not let it be named among you. Instead, try to live a life to please God. Try to live a spiritual lifestyle. And what I can say to you is that you can do this through reading the Word of God. I'm not saying that it will be easy to get up every day and read your Bible, because the enemy, may I tell you, enough time you take up your Bible for read and you get distracted. You feel so disheartened, you can't bother. But just read one verse. Just pull your Bible. Me used to tell my best friend, say, just pull your Bible and the first verse of the Bible go upon. Just look upon it and read it. And make it minister to you. Just read it. A verse a day keep the devil away. A verse a day will keep you rooted. A verse a day will keep you pushing. A verse a day will just encourage you not to do what you had planned to do for the day. So I'm here to say that the spiritual lifestyle is not hard. It can become a bit overwhelming at time, but it is possible when you put God in the midst. So I'm gonna pray for you guys and try to live a life to please God today. Basically, that's what a spiritual lifestyle is. It's not impossible. If I can do it, if my friends can do it, if my parents can do it, then you can do it. Like, try God today. Like, try it. He will help you. As long as you accept him, he will hold your hand and bring you through, right? So, Lord, Eternal Father, I want to thank you for another day. I want to thank you for your peace, your kindness, your love, your mercies, and your grace that you have towards us, oh God. I give you thanks, oh Father, that when we call upon you, oh God, that you blot out all our transgressions, Almighty God. Father God, I lift you up and I exalt your name, oh God, because when we call upon you, oh Father, you create in us a clean heart, and you are there to renew your right spirit within us, oh God. Father God, I give you all the praise and all the glory and all the honor, mighty God, because I know that you are able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we could ask or think. Right now, mighty Father, I place everyone before you, all our youths, all our children, and our adults that are watching this video, Almighty God. You see, mighty Father, at times where it becomes overwhelming, oh God, where the things of life, oh God, become so pressuring, Almighty Father. But, oh God, we see that in this life, we're trying to live a life to please you, Almighty Father. So, Almighty God, we see, Almighty God, God, where so many things can turn against us, oh God. But we know that through you today, Almighty God, that when we trust in you, oh God, you will keep us going another mile. You will strengthen us, oh God. You will, mighty Father, fill us up, oh God, as empty vessels, Almighty God, to go through life, oh God, in holding your hand as, oh, you will hold our hands. So right now, mighty God, those persons who are feeling dismayed, those persons who are feeling disheartened, Almighty God, those persons who have faltered, oh God, I pray right now, oh Father, that you will just visit them right now, Almighty God, that you will just give them a word, that you will just give them a song, Almighty God, so that they can hold on to you, oh God, so that they can remember that you have given them greatness to overcome, mighty God, all the obstacles, all the things of this world, Almighty God, and instead can live to please you, Almighty Father, because you are within them, and mighty God, in you we are victors, in you we are triumphant, Almighty God. Even so, mighty God, I pray, even now, right now, Almighty God, I pray that you will even visit those who are feeling hopeless, mighty God. I want you, mighty God, to even remind them right now, oh Father, that there is life in you and there is hope in you right now, Almighty God. I pray right now, oh Father, for your will to be done in their life, in everyone's life, mighty God, that is watching this even now. In your name I pray, amen. Have a wonderful day, guys, and be blessed.